I'm Ugeshwara. Today we are discussing about class 12 physics chapter number 7 alternating current, and today we are discussing about that the exercise of this topic. So in this topic of we are discussing of the all the illustration of the illustration of the textbook, and also we are discussing about that the exercise of the textbook. So we will discussing in this lectures. See in this slide, this is our example number one or illustration of example number one. A light bulb is rated at the 100 volt for watt for a 220 volt supply. So 100 watt is the power, 220 volt is the voltage. So find the resistance of the bulb. So we need to first of all find out the resistance of the bulb. So we first of all P is equal to V square upon R. So due to this equation, we will find out that the V square is equals to, there are the 220 volts and the 100 watt, it is a power. So we will get that the resistance value, it is equals to 484 ohms. Okay, so and now we know the VRMS value. So VRMS value, it is equals to Vm upon under root 2. So Vm upon under 2, it means VRMS, the value of VRMS, Vm, it is the maximum value of voltage, peak voltage, is equals to under root 2 into VRMS. So VRMS, it is equals to V into 2, V, it is equals to 2, it is equals to 220 volt. So here V multiply by the 2, under root 2 multiply by the V, so we will get that the value, it is equals to 311.08 volt. Also we have a P, it is equals to VRMS into IRMS into cos phi. Okay, so the purely resistive circuit has a phi is equals to T zero. So the V, it is equals to V, it is equals to VRMS into IRMS, it is equals to, we will get that the IM value of IRMS, it is equals to P upon VRMS. So VRMS, it is equals to 100 upon 220, it is equals to 220. So we will get that the 0.4545 amperes. So this is our example number first. Now our second example is that a light bulb is rated at the 200 volt and 230 volt. So we will get that the first of the resistance of the bulb, and second of the peak voltage of the source, and the third one is RMS current through the bulb. So the A, we will get that the similarly from this equation, we will get the answer is that first one is the resistance from this equation, P is equals to V square upon R. Second one is that Vm, so then Vm, it is equals to under root 2 into VRMS, so we will get also this value. Then after we have a value, I, it is equals to current, so we need to determine the I from this equation. IRMS, it is equals to P upon VRMS, so you can find out by yourself. Okay, now our example number 3, a pure inductor of 25 millihenry. Okay, so 25 millihenry is connected to a source of 220 volt. Find the inductive resistance and the RMS current in the circuit if the frequency of the source is 50 hertz. Okay, so magnitude of the inductive reactance is omega L, it is equals to omega into XL, it is equals to omega into L, but omega, it is equals to 2 pi into F. So 2 pi into F, it is into multiply by L. L is, it is the inductance. So see here, a 2 multiplied by pi, it is equals to 3.50. F is equals to, see here, F is equal, our frequency is that. So frequency F, it is equals to 50, and multiply by the 25 into 10 raised to minus 3. Here, see here, millihenry. So we will convert into the henry. So we will get that the 25 into 10 raised to minus 3 henry. So we will get that the final answer, it is equals to 3.7.8285 ohms. Okay, this is also measured in the inductive reactance, also measure in the ohm. So this is represented by the ohm, 7.85 ohms. It is not a resistance, but it looks like a resistance. So here now VRMS value of VRMS, it is equals to IRMS into XL. Okay, so IXL, it is equals to IRMS, is equals to VRMS upon XL. So we will get the final answer is that 220 upon X, value of XL, it is equals to 7.85. So we will get that the final answer is, it is equals to 28.025. It is a current. Okay, see, we need to determine the RMS current in the circuit. So we are find out that the value of RMS current. Now see here, also the a pure inductor have a 5 Henry is connected to a source 220 volt. Find the inductive reactance and the RMS current in the circuit if in the frequency of the source is 60 hertz. So we will determine from the previous example, example number 3. We will also find out from this equation XL is equals to omega into L, and also we will find out the VRMS is equals to IRMS into XL. So from this formula we can find out this example, so you can do also by yourself. Okay, now we have another example is that a lamp is connected in a series with a capacitor. Predicting your observation for a DC and AC connection, what happen in each case if the capacitance of the capacitor is reduced? Okay, now first of all, when the DC source is connected to a series combination of lamp and capacitor, the current flow through the lamp till the capacitor get charged up. Okay, but after that no current flow through the lamp because capacitor offer infinite resistance to the flow of direct and the hence block DC current. Okay, there the DC current will be blocked. After that the capacitor will be charged. So during the charging of capacitor, current through the RC circuit is it is equals to I0 e raised to minus t upon RC, which is also called the transistance current. Okay, this current is known as that the transistance current, which keep on charging with the time, giving rise to displacement current between the plate of capacitor. Hence the current flow through the capacitor, but once the capacitor become fully charged, that at time t tends to infinity part practically last time. So it is I is equals to I0 di e raised to infinity, it is equals to zero. So see here, when the capacitor is reduced after the charging over, no current would flow through the capacitor. So when the AC source is connected to the series combination of lamp and the capacitor, current flow through the lamp continuously because the continuously charging and discharging of the capacitor giving rising to continuous flow or displacement current between the plates of capacitor. Hence the lamp glow continuously. Here RMS value of the current passing through the lamp is IRMS, it is equals to VRMS upon under root R square plus XC square. See, where the C is the capacitance and reduce the magnitude of the capacitive reactance, it is equals to XC, it is equals to 1 upon omega C increase, and so IRMS decrease, and so the lamp will emit less amount of light, it would become a dim. Okay, now this is also the sixth number is the lamp is connected in a series with the inductor. Predict your observation of for a DC and AC connection, what happen in each case if the inductance of the inductor is reduced. When DC source is connected, the bulb will glow gradually more and more. When AC source is connected, bulb will glow with the less brightness. When the inductance is decreased, this brightness will be decreased. Okay. Now, example number is that the light bulb and open coil inductor are connected to an AC source through a key as a figure. So, in figure, so the switch is closed and after some time, an iron rod is inserted into interior of the inductor to glow of a light bulb or increase, B decrease, C unchanged as in iron rod in the inserted. Give your answer with the reason. So see, first of all, before inserting the iron rod, coil is in air core inductor with the inductance is L0 is equals to mu 0 N square A upon L. We will discussing in this chapter number 4. What will happen after that we will discussing in this chapter, but first of all you can just mug up in this chapter. After inserting iron rod, coil is magnetic core inductor with the inductance is L, it is equals to mu N square A upon L. So mu is greater than mu 0, and so L is greater than L 0. So XL will be increased considerably. Okay, hence the IRMS value, it is equals to VRMS upon under root R square plus X square will be decreased. Okay, see here, this is bulb will be emit light with the quite low intensity. See here, after that After closing the key in the above circuit, after some time a glass rod is inserted in the inductor. Will the brightness of bulb give the answer with reason increase, decrease or remain same? Brightness will be remain same because inductance of the inductor remains same. Okay. So now we have another example is that at an airport, a person is made to walk through the doorway of a metal detector for a security reason. If see he carrying anything made of metal, the metal detect emit a sound. On what a principle does this detector work? We have shows that the value of inductors. Okay, first of all, whenever we enter the metal detector, on that time any metal thing will be produce the sound. So why will it happen? So at the airport entrance, there is a kept a metal detector of a doorway type. Female of frame of this doorway consists of the coil having a large number of light wounded turns. There is a connected with a capacitor. The LC circuit is in reason with the AC source connected with it. Suppose the coil has a inductance L0 is equals to mu 0 N square A upon L. So now when any person carrying some metallic object walk through this doorway, inductance of coil change from L0 to L. So where L is equals to mu N square A upon L. So where L is greater than L0. Because of this, there is a sudden change in the impedance of the circuit and hence the sudden change in the current passing through the LC circuit. This sudden change is in current is immediately not, and the electronic circuit kept in the metal detector and sound beep 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 beep. This alarm gives indirect proof that the person walking through the doorway is carrying some metallic object. Okay, now our example number 10. The person our 100 ohm resistance is connected to 220 volt and 50 hertz supplies. Okay, what is the RMS value of the current in the circuit? Okay, what is the net power consumed over the full cycle? So first of all, RMS value. So IRMS, it is equals to VRMS upon Z. So VRZ is equals to R. So see here, Z is equals to R. So VRMS upon R is equals to, we will get that the RMS value is equals to 2.2 ampere. Okay, now for second is that, what is the net power consumed over the full cycle? So PV is equals to V square RMS upon R. We will discuss in the first example, so it is a similarly for that. So we will get that the final answer is that 40 P is equals to 484 volt. Okay, now second example number 11, the peak voltage of an AC supply is 300 volt. What is the RMS voltage? Okay, so VRMS voltage is equals to Vm by 2. So we have a voltage V is equals to 300 volt, and the value of 1 upon under root 2, it will be gives us the 1.414. So we will get that the answer is that 212.2 volt of RMS value. And we have second thing is that the RMS value of current in the AC circuit is 10 ampere. What is the peak current? So peak current Im. Okay, so peak current is known as the Im. So Im is equals to under root 2 into RMS value. So we will get that the answer is that 14.14 ampere. So now we have another example is that it has a 44 millihenry inductor in a connected to 220 volt. It has a contained 50 hertz frequency. Determine the RMS value of the current circuit. So we will show also in this previous slides, XL it is equals to omega into L. From this phenomena we will get that the value of XL, and thus we need to determine the RMS IRMS value. So IRMS it is equals to VRMS upon Z. So we will get that the value IRMS in XL it is equals to Z is equals to XL. So we will get that the answer is that 15.92 ampere. Now second, and we have another example is that, what will you find out? The 60 microfarad capacitor is connected to the 110 volt and the 60 hertz AC supply. Determine, see here, capacitor and upper in this phenomena there are the inductors. So inductor XL it is equals to inductive inductance, it is equals to XL is equals to omega L, and see here the capacitive reactance is equals to XC, and it is denoted by the 1 upon omega C. So 1 upon omega C it is equals to 1 upon 2 pi F into C. So we will get that the XC is equals to 44.23 omega. So see, it is equals to 60 microfarad. So microfarad convert into the farad. So we will get back the 60 into multiply 10 raised to minus 6. Okay. So IRMS it is equals to VRMS upon, now we need to determine the value of current in the circuit. So IRMS it is equals to VRMS upon Z. Due to these things, we will get that the final answer is that 110 VRMS value of VRMS it is equals to 110 divided by the Z is equals to 44.23. So we will get that the current is 2.487 amp strong. So now our example number 14. What is the net power absorbed by each circuit over a complete cycle? Explain your answer. What is the power absorbed by each circuit? Power or complete cycle. So see here, P is equals to power, P is equals to V into I. So P is equals to VRMS into IRMS into cos phi. So see here, P V into RMS into cos phi. So cos pi by 2 will be 0. Okay, pi by 2 will be 0, and the cos A, so AC current will be 0. Suppose VRMS into IRMS cos phi. Okay, where phi is equals to minus pi by 2. Then on that time also pi will be 0. So for purely capacitive AC circuit, the phi will be minus pi by 2 radian in above frequency. See in this example, now this is the section B. It will be asked, this examples asked will be in the section B in the its career 3 marks. Okay, now see here, 15 microfarad capacitor is connected to 220 volt 15 hertz source. So find the capacitive reactance and the current RMS and the peak in the circuit. If the frequency is double, what happened to capacitive reactance and the current? So see here, the one XC is equals to 1 upon omega C, 1 upon 2 pi FC. So we will get that the 1 upon 2 into 3.4 into 15 into 10 raised to minus 6. 15 into 10 raised to minus 6. Why? Because of that, the micro farad. So we need to convert into the farad. So 1 micro will be 10 raised to minus 6 farad. 1 micro, it will be 10 raised to minus 6. So see here, IRMS value it is equals to VRMS upon XC. So VRMS is that the 220 volt and XC is equals to 2212.3. So we will get that the final answer it is equals to 1.036 ampere. Okay, now we know that the IRMS it is equals to Im upon root 2. Im it is equals to root 2 into IRMS. So IRMS it is equals to 1.0363 multiplied by the root 2 1.41. So we will get that the final answer is that 1.46 amp strong. Here current through the capacitor oscillate between the minus 1.46 ampere and the minus 1.465 into ampere and the minus 1.465 keep itself the ahead of voltage by amount of minus pi by 2 radian. Okay, after the frequency is made double, XC is equals to 1 upon 2 pi FC would become half, and so current IRMS would become a double. Okay. Now the 17 is that the 10 microfarad capacitor is connected to 230 volt 50 hertz frequency. Find the capacitive reactance and the current in the circuit. If the frequency is double, what happened to capacitive reactance and the current? It is similar for the example number 50. So we are not discussing in this here. So first, please keep in mind, you will do your by yourself and do try to waste. And after, if you have any kind of problem, then I will give you a solution. Otherwise, you can do by yourself. Okay. Now, number 17 is that a resistors of 200 ohm and the capacitor of 15 microfarad are connected in a series to 220 volt of and 50 hertz frequency source. The calculate current in the circuit. So current it is equals to IRMS it is equals to VRMS upon R square plus XC square. So VRMS upon R square plus XC is equals to 1 upon 2 pi F into C. So 1 upon 4 pi square F square C square. So we will get that the answer is that IRMS is equal to 220 upon under root 200 plus 1 upon 4 into 3.4 square multiply 15 square multiply 15 into 10 to minus 6 square. So we will get that the answer by solving this equation. We will get that the IRMS is equal to 0.755 m strong. sorry, 755 ampere. Okay, now VR, it is equals to IRMS into A. So VR, it is equals to voltage of resistance I, VR RMS into A. So we will get that the VRMS is 0.755 multiplied by 200. So we will get that the 151 voltage. Okay, now VC, we need to find out the VC. So VC, it is equals to IRMS into XC. So IRMS multiplied by 1 upon 2 pi FC. So we will get that the 0.75 multiplied 1 upon 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 15 raised to minus 6. So we will get that the final answer is that 160.3 volt. Okay, now here VR and VC are not in the same phase. Okay, here VR and VC is not in same phase, hence we cannot make the algebraic sum to get the resultant voltage. So we need to determine by the phase difference between VR and VC is pi by 2. So resultant voltage can found out from following phasor diagram. Okay, so we need to determine the phasor diagram. So we will get that the V is equals to under root V square R plus VR square plus VC square. So we will get that the final answer is that V is equals to 220 volt. Above voltage is equals to RMS value to off source voltage. Now a resistance of 100 ohms and the capacitor of 25 microfarad are connected in series to 220 volt 50 hertz AC source. Calculate the current in the circuit, calculate the voltage RMS across the resistors and the capacitor in the algebraic sum of this voltage more than the source voltage. If yes, resolve the paradox. Okay, now so it is also similar for the above equation, so you can find out by yourself. A it is equals to 1, Z is equals to Z, it means there are the volt resistance and the resistance and also capacitor. So Z is equals to under root R square plus XC square under root R square plus, see here, under root R square plus XC square. So due to this equation, you can find out by yourself. So we will get that the answer Z is equals to 1.62 into ohm, IR is equals to 1.358 Armstrong, VR is equals to 1.135.8 V, VC is equals to 1.84.4 voltage, and the VRC, the value, it is equals to 220 volt. Okay. Now, for circuit used for the transporting electric power, a lower power factor implies larger power loss in the transmission. Explain. Second is that power factor can offer in improve by use of a capacitor of appropriate capacitance in the circuit. Explain. The average power sent in the series AC circuit is P is equals to VRMS IRMS into cos phi. So IRMS it is equals to P upon VRMS into cos phi. From the above equation, we can say that the for given value of power to be delivered at a given voltage, P and VRMS are constant. Hence, if power factor cos phi is small, then IRMS would increase, and so power loss I square RMS into R will be more. There would be greater transmission loss. So see here, suppose in a given series AC circuit, current I is lags behind the voltage by an angle phi. Here power factor is cos phi, it is equals to R upon Z. Here resultant current phasor can be represented as I is equals to IP plus IQ. So resultant current phasor can be represented by I is equals to IP plus IQ. So where IP is power of component of I, IQ is wattless component of I. So angle between the IP in V is the 90, and so it wattless. So now if we connect a capacitor of appropriate capacitance in parallel to above circuit, then we can have a IQ is equal and opposite to IQ. Here IP is leading and IQ is lagging by same amount, and so they cancel out each other, and then phi becomes 0, and so cos phi is equals to 1 and maximum, and so IRMS it is equals to P upon VRMS into cos phi is equals to minimum. Okay, from this Now, a sinusoidal voltage of peak value, it is equals to 3√3 volt and the frequency is 15 hertz is applied to series LCR circuit in which R is equals to 3 ohm, L it is equals to 25.40 millihenry and the C it is equals to 796 microfarad. Then find out the impedance of the circuit, the phase difference between the voltage across the source and the current, the power dissipated in the circuit and the power factor. Okay, so first of all, XL it is equals to omega L. Due to the above equation, we can find out the also in this thing. After that, we can find out the XC. So you can also find out the XC and then XC is equals to 1 upon omega C. So from this equation, you can find out by yourself. And then impedance of given series AC circuit. Impedance is equals to Z. So Z is equals to R square plus root R square. Under root R square plus XC XL minus XC whole square. So you can find, you can get the value, it is equals to 5 ohm. So the phase difference between the voltage and current can be found as follow. 10 pi is equals to XL minus XC. So you can find out the 4/3. So the 10 pi is equals to 1.33. But the from the table of natural tangent table, so 53 degree and 8 minute, you can get that the 1.335. I will explain in the next lecture how we will show that the log table. Voltage leads ahead of the current by an angle 53 degree and 8 minute. Power dissipated in the form of heat is P is equals to I square R. So I square R is equals to Vrms upon Z square R. So Vrms it is equals to Vm upon under root 2z. So Vm square upon 2z square into R. So Vm square it is equals to 283 square divided into 3 divided by the 2 into z is equals to our 5. So we can get that the value it is equals to P it is equals to 4805 volt. Okay, now the we have a 10 pi is equals to 3 and 4. So so we will get that the opposite angle, opposite side is that, sorry, hypotenuse is that we will find out the phi. So cos phi is equals to pi s opposite near side divided by the opposite hypotenuse. So it is equals to 3/5. So it will be guessed that the 0.6. So cos phi is equals to R by Z it is equals to 0.6. Okay, from this we will discuss similarly a sinusoidal voltage of peak value is 230 volt, frequency is 50 hertz, applied to a series LCR circuit in R is equals to 6 ohm, L is equals to 50.96 millihenry and this is 398 microfarad. You can find out by yourself this equation. This question is similar for the 20 number example. So by find out your, if you are by yourself and you can do by yourself. If any kind of problems, then comment in the comment box. Okay, thank you guys. We after remaining those examples we will discussing in the next lecture.